What do you think? You want to make an alliance? Cover our own asses?
I don't know if I can take you seriously or not.
I'm being 100% serious. Just, you can't make it obvious at all. Like, I'm carrying logs with you right now. It's gotta end.
Right.
Alright?
Alright.
Do you want to?
Yeah.
Amber and I have an alliance. For obvious reasons. She's beautiful, obviously. Any idiot can see that. But I'll keep my word. No matter what to her. I trust her. I don't think she's gonna screw me. Here's the thing. Amber and I have been flirting with each other since we got out here. We have an alliance together. She probably thinks she's playing me. I probably think I'm playing her. Who knows how it's gonna turn out. One thing's for sure though. Can only be one winner in this game.
Oh.
Amber and I, we're not so sure if it's a good idea if we bathe each other. Because the tribe might get the wrong idea. However, soap and scrubs with the women.
Let's just do this all day long, every day.
Momentum is huge in this game. When you have it, you want to keep it. Rupert has a squeaky clean image and attitude. Something about him I just don't trust. So I formed an alliance with him. If you honestly honor your alliance, you go to the end.
Right.
No matter what. Yes. But always somebody like gets
one
greedy at one point.
Yes.
Once it gets to the final four, then we can you know, every man for themselves.
Exactly.
If you guys are cool
with it,
we have my word.
I'm beautiful with it.
It's done. So I got alliances with everybody now, except Sue and Alicia. I mean, you can turn around tomorrow and kick Jenna and Rupert off. They could be here as sacrificial lambs. I gotta see what's going on. It's my game, buddy. I was on the state championship golf team in my high school. Amber is slamming. She's sweet, she's beautiful, she's funny, she's got a great personality. Her ass is smoking too. Amber and I have been fooling around a little bit out here. I mean, it's all in good fun. I'm definitely attracted to her. It'd be nice to have $1 million and take the girl away too. Rupert's all excited about having the Hawaiian sling. You know, it's his baby. Now he can catch a fish and show how much he's worth to the tribe.
That's his whole life, is that spear.
First of all, the guy looks like Grizzly Adams, but he thinks he's Aquaman in the ocean.
My name is Rupert. I'm a big and strong fisherman in the Pearl Island.
And he comes back with a bag of fish, feeling all good about himself.
My God, it took all I had to stop.
Is that the 20 pounder you were talking about?
Uh-huh. Yeah!
I proceeded to go into the water and catch 11 fish myself. The city kid from Boston with the Hawaiian sling versus Aquaman.
All right, drop your buffs. The only change is Amber. All right, so Lex, Jerry, Amber, Shean, Kathy, you will be living now at Shapira's camp. Boston Rob, Big Tom, Alicia, Rupert, Jenna, you're going to Mogo Mogo.
I care about her. It kills me to have her over there by herself. I know she's tough, but... so much of the reason why she was having such a good time and why I was having such a good time was because of each other. Here's to Amber.
I don't really care that the other team has our camp now. I don't even really care that they have all of our possessions. As much as we're crying about it over here, it doesn't matter. What aggravates me is they got my girl over there.
I promised Amber I would take her to the end with me, but I gotta figure out a way to get her there. I'm gonna do whatever I can do. Keep her around as long as possible over there. Pretty much the next move I make is gonna have consequences for everybody left in this game. Serious consequences.
Mogo Mogo's right, you win immunity. Congratulations.
Carry on. If you can, if you can.
Lex, move it out.
I hope Amber's still here. Said some prayers last night and this morning. Not much I can do about it. Maybe Lex came through for me, and that would be great. As soon as we merged, Lex comes running over to me. Rob, make me feel comfortable. Tell me that I'm safe. Tell me that I'm safe.
Well, I'm making the deal, save Amber, and I'm gonna help you later on. You guys didn't really believe that, did you? Come on. I've been playing the game since the second I got here. It's all a game, everything. Make no mistake about it, I am playing the game.
Listen, this is the way it has to go down. We need to get rid of Lex tomorrow.
He's got it! Pops it off, comes from behind! Wins the game!
Nice effort.
I should have let you know that I appreciate everything you did to save Amber, but myself, Amber, Big Tom, Jenna, Alicia, and
Rupert
have agreed to stay together as a group.
And let me tell you something right now. That was not a game or strategy decision. It was a brother coming to another brother saying, friend to friend. And you know what?
Right.
I had my game all worked out. And if I had gotten rid of Amber, you know what I would have come in here with? I would have come in here with my numbers advantage. And I did that just because you're my friend. I screwed my own game up.
I'm sorry, buddy.
The word I gave you was that if I can take care of you, I will. I'm sorry, I cannot.
10th person voted out of Survivor All-Stars and the first member of our jury, Lex.
Everything went down according to plan. It was kind of a tough one, to tell you the truth. Lex is a friend, but we are playing a game. I never promised Lex an alliance.
Austin Rob wins immunity.
I got a proposition for you. We have been living together for some time, and we had some bad blood yesterday. Is there any way, if I forego seeing the video, everybody could get their letter? Please. I think it's the right thing to do, because everybody's hurting and everybody's missing home.
Great offer. I can make that trade.
I don't remember the last time I was emotional about anything, ever. And you know, I do feel bad. My brother spent all the time making the tape and everything. But this way, everybody won. It wasn't about me. It wasn't about strategy. It was about strategy to a degree. It's a good move, yeah, it is. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you it's not. For me, my family's the most important thing in the world. More than anything else. More than money, more than anything. But I'm still getting a million.
My main alliance still is with Amber. Of course she's playing the game. She may be playing me, I don't know. I don't think so. I really don't. I think it's genuine what's going on. I could be the biggest sucker in history, and if so, hey, she had me fooled.
I mean, at this point, you get so fed up of being with the people that you're with. You don't want to hear their stories anymore. You're just drained. You're tired, you're cranky, you're hungry, you're not sleeping at night. And it's just like, shut up, don't talk to me.
Boston Rob, no trouble at all. Show me those keys. Congratulations. Yeah. Got yourself a truck, man. Woo! Nice job.
Thank you.
Ever had a new truck before?
First one.
Really?
Thank you very much.
One person coming with you.
Gotta be Amber.
Really?
Second place, and been with me from day one.
So it's Amber and Boston Rob.
You know, anybody that's won a car during Survivor has never actually won Survivor. Well, that wasn't gonna discourage me from winning. I'll tell you right now, it was worth it.
Oh, wait, whoa. One more thing. There's one more thing. Come with me. One of the added benefits of being selected by Boston Rob, something for you, Amber.
Oh, my God.
Shut up! Are you serious?
Amber, right here.
No!
Another new car. Only this one's yours.
No!
Malibu Max.
You gave me a card. Do you realize?
You earned it. You earned it.
No!
Time alone with Amber was unbelievable. For the first time, I didn't have to think about the game at all.
You have an unbelievable time, you know that?
Me too.
It was definitely special to me. A lot more special than when we started this adventure. But I mean, still, you can't lose sight of the fact that you're playing a game for $1 million. I'm not gonna forfeit the million to anybody, including her. Maybe you're trying to play both sides or something, but you keep telling me that you keep saying you want to vote me out.
I won't change the line.
Huh?
I won't change the line. Why would I? It'd be stupid of me.
I wouldn't say that if it wasn't true.
That's what I'm saying. I think Rupert has been a truthful man. But if he told you that,
yeah, he told me that.
Well, then he's a lying son of a bitch.
The reason I did this was to get them at each other's throats so that neither of them will have enough sense to go to each other and try to get me and Amber off. And I think I succeeded.
Chaboga Mogo. Austin Robb wins immunity.
Just like that, Austin Robb,
definitely.
You have final immunity.
Yeah.
The last time, immunity. You're going to the final two?
Amber played a solid game, but Amber did ride my coattails the entire way. I don't know, maybe she conned me the whole way. Maybe it's the biggest scam in the history of Survivor. If I go with Jenna, maybe more people are annoyed at Jenna. But then I look like a complete ass because I'll sell out absolutely anybody to win this game. I don't know if I can or cannot win against either one of them. I keep changing my own mind 50 times a day.
The 16th person voted out and the final member of our jury, Jenna.
15 minutes after the game started, we were able to work as a team. Even when we got separated and weren't together, we were still able to work through it as a team. I mean, in a game where trust is fleeting, to have a partnership with someone, an alliance with someone that you can trust, that's huge.
They
thought we were, you know, screwing around, flirting, da 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 da.
Little did they know that.
They never had a clue. They'd never seen it coming.
Playing the game too.
You know, I said in the beginning also that this game, Survivor, was basically like Charles Darwin's premise, survival of the fittest. The species that's best able to adapt to certain situations while outlive the others. And I think, as a team, Amber and I will most able to adapt to certain situations. See, this time a jury is made up of people who know me, and they know how I am. I'm sure people took this game very, very personal. And that's their own freaking problem. I outwitted, I outlasted, and I feel I outplayed them all. The feeling that I have inside me right now is worth the sleep deprivation, the lack of food, the suffering, the highs, the lows of the game. It's worth everything. I did everything I wanted to do out here. I did it to the best of my ability. I gave 110% every single day. And I'm sitting in the final two with Amber. I'm proud of the way I played, and I have no regrets. Obviously, the last 39 days have been long, emotional. I didn't want to let personal relationships interfere in this game. In the end, that's where everything started to go south for me. Obviously, when you have a jury that you have to vote out, it's going to come back to haunt you in one way or the other. But I would like you guys to consider how I play the game as a player, always trying to do well for my team at the same time, trying to look out for myself. Thank you.
What kind of a friend are you, Rob? What kind of a friend were you to me? You asked me to do you a favor. Bro to bro, friend to friend, and I did the only thing I could do, and that was to answer the call of a friend in need. You repaid that by putting a knife in my back. As good as your game was, you sold out your values, sold out your character, and you sold out your friends for a stack of greenbacks. I hope it was worth it, because that money will never be enough to buy it all back.
Rob, you just need to know that I was crushed. Obviously, look at me. I've been off this thing for 12 days. You were like a kid, son. And I was crushed that you didn't address what we had. We merged and we were outnumbered. I got it. I got it. I got that we were outplayed. I got it. But I just can't imagine any game in the world where you can check your friendships at the door. It's just not in my chemistry and my makeup, and I thought it wasn't in yours. But I just want you to know that you used some friendships as stepping stones to get there. And it's been a devilish game. But I think you could have taken a parallel course where these people wouldn't have been left in carnage, and they would have been feeling a little bit better about their decisions tonight. And maybe that's some immaturity, I don't know, but there was another path right next to you, you didn't see it, that you could have thrown us just an ounce of respect.
I just want to say no hard feelings.
No hard feelings, Tom.
Don't be stupid, stupid. I may have failed for once. I failed for it twice. Not this time.
I'll play the game
as hot as I could, but I'd be naive to be able to sit in one of the last two seats and think that people on that side were gonna feel all right about the way I play the game. It got a lot more personal than I thought it ever would. And from tonight, I was expecting it to be hot. I wasn't expecting it to be nearly as hot as it was. I had fun, and I'm sorry. That's all I have to say, really. Well, you know what, Jeff? Regardless of what happens here tonight with the vote, I feel like I already won. I have the most special girl in the entire world sitting here right next to me. If you don't mind, I'd like to say something to her. You're the most amazing person I've ever met in my entire life. And I want to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you with all my heart. Will you marry me?
The winner of Survivor All-Stars.